Puss in Boots. There once was a miller who had three sons. He also had a mill, a mule, and a cat. One day, the miller passed away. The oldest son got the mill. The middle son got the mule. And the youngest son got the cat. The youngest son was very sad. He didn't know how he was going to make a living. But the cat was very clever. He said, "Master, don't worry. If you give me clothes and a pair of boots, I will help you." So the youngest son gave the cat clothes and a pair of boots. When the cat put them on, he became Puss in Boots. Puss in Boots went into the forest and caught a rabbit. He put the rabbit in his pocket and went to the king's castle. He said, "This rabbit is my master's gift to the king." The king thought it was a bit strange. He asked, "Who is your master?" "He is the Marquis of Carabas," said Puss in Boots, giving the miller's son an impressive title. The king liked the gift very much. Over the next few days, Puss in Boots brought a gift to the king every day and said it was from the Marquis of Carabas. One day, the king and his daughter were out touring in their carriage. Puss in Boots had an idea. He said to his master, "Jump into the river and take a bath." The miller's son jumped into the river, and Puss in Boots hid his clothes under a big tree. The king and the princess saw the miller's son in the river. "Help!" Puss in Boots yelled. "The Marquis of Carabas has fallen into the river, and he can't swim!" The king remembered the gifts, so he commanded his guards to save him and give him a splendid suit of clothes. The miller's son was unusually handsome. With his new clothes on, he looked like a real marquis. The princess liked him. The miller's son was invited to ride in the carriage with the king and the princess. Puss in Boots went in front of the carriage. He saw a big field and farmers working the land. The land belonged to a big, evil ogre. The ogre owned a lot of land and had many servants. Puss in Boots said to the farmers, "I am Puss in Boots. My master is the Marquis of Carabas. The king will be passing by. Tell him that this land belongs to the Marquis of Carabas and that he is a good man. He will help you." When the king saw the big stretch of land, he could not help but ask, "Whose land is this? It is so beautiful." It belongs to the Marquis of Carabas, said the farmers. The king smiled. Puss in Boots continued to run ahead of the carriage. Puss in Boots saw a huge castle, but the castle belonged to that big, evil ogre. Puss in Boots thought of a way to trick the ogre, so he knocked on the castle's big door. The ogre opened the door.
What are you doing here, little cat?
The ogre roared. I hear that you can magically transform. Can you transform into a lion?
Of course I can, yelled the ogre.
The ogre said a few magic words and suddenly became a lion. Puss in Boots was so scared by the lion that he began shivering in fright. The ogre said a few more magic words and changed back to normal. Can you transform into a mouse? Puss in Boots asked the ogre.
Of course I can, yelled the ogre.
He said a few more magic words, and in the flash of an eye, he changed into a tiny little mouse. Puss in Boots immediately lunged upon him and swallowed him whole. The ogre died. And all the servants in the castle thanked Puss in Boots. Thank you, little cat, they said. Tell the king that your master is the Marquis of Carabas. He is a very good man. He will help you, Puss in Boots said. When the king arrived at the castle, Puss in Boots said, Welcome to the castle of the Marquis of Carabas. The servants had prepared a sumptuous banquet. The king was very happy. He thought to himself,
The Marquis of Carabas is a very good man, and also very rich.
The Marquis of Carabas liked the princess, and the princess liked him. They had fallen in love. The Marquis of Carabas said to the king, I love your daughter. I would like to have her hand in marriage. The king smiled and said,
This Sunday, you shall marry my daughter.
The Marquis of Carabas and the princess were married. Everyone was very happy. But the happiest of them all was Puss in Boots. No longer did he have to catch mice. Now he lived in a castle and could eat fish every day.